What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the show. So today we're going to take a look and a listen to Representative Frankel. She's going to be talking about Social Security reform and a Social Security increase. But first off, if you guys can do me a favor, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit that little bell notification, and then click all. By clicking all, you'll get notified anytime we post a video. We do daily videos here, so by clicking the bell notification, clicking all, you should be getting updated every day. And just a reminder, thank you for your support. I really appreciate it. And you can also support us by joining our membership. You get customized emojis as well as custom badges. And one final thing that I'm asking of you guys is to sign our petition. So if you have not signed our petition, go over to change.org. I'll have the link in the comment section. It'll be pinned at the very top. That way you can sign this petition to increase Social Security benefits. We're going to be sending out letters in the coming weeks. And well, those letters are going to say, look at the support that we have. Look, we put together a change.org petition. We have thousands of signatures. And hopefully that will have some sway when it comes to some of these lawmakers, and maybe we'll get them on the same page when it comes to moving forward with reforming and providing an expansion to Social Security benefits. Okay, so let's go ahead and listen to Representative Frankel. Here we go.
Thank you so much for your leadership on this issue. To Mr. Neguse for getting us here, and to my colleagues. I think, Mr. Larson, I've joined you on this discussion for about 10 years or more now. I want to tell you about one of my constituents. Her name is Janet Swayback. She's in her 80s. She lives in Delray Beach, Florida, retired. When she was a very young girl, she lost her dad at a very early age, and since she watched her mom struggle with their own family bills, and so Janet, to help the family, began working at the age of 17. And so now I got to get my math right. She's been working 50 years, so I guess that makes her, I don't know. Someone add that up for me. But here's the point. Let me tell you some of the things that she's done over these years. She was a nurse working in a hospital, working countless hours taking care of patients. She moved to Florida, and she became a director of a skilled nursing facility. And then she worked at Alzheimer's patients at the Alzheimer Community Care, probably one of the most difficult assignments a healthcare provider could have. And she managed one of our crisis center hotlines. She retired about 8 years ago, and now is one of almost 200,000 seniors in my district, or I like to say, seasoned adults. We're seasoned adults in my home district of Palm Beach County, and like the 66 million other Americans who rely on Social Security to meet their needs. And Mr. Larson, I like the point you made that not only does Social Security meet the needs of so many of these seniors, but our seniors are great economic generators. I know where I live, if not for the seniors' economic activity, we'd be in pretty bad shape. Janet told me that she fears that without Social Security, she would have to turn to her children, somewhat like her mother turned to her when she was young. So here it is. She's worked her whole life paying in Social Security to get benefits. She and millions of other Americans, nurses, school teachers, janitors, construction workers, they worked under the sacred promise that when they turned 65, they would be able to retire with comfort and dignity. And now, House Republicans want to break that promise. Their recently proposed budget slashes Social Security benefits, raises the retirement age, raises Medicare costs, all while promising another giant tax break for their wealthy friends and large corporations. And I know, and I'll say this, and I hope we all agree, that no one who works their entire life should retire into poverty. Social Security is an earned benefit that Americans have already paid for with each and every of their paycheck. And President Biden and House Democrats and senators are committed to defending it from Republican cuts and securing it with meaningful legislation that requires our wealthiest citizens to pay their fair share. So I am proud to stand here with my colleagues, standing up for Social Security, keeping it secure, and honoring our most seasoned citizens. And with that, I yield back.
Okay, so that was Representative Frankel talking about the seasoned adults. You know, I think it's really interesting. She's talking about the fact that, you know, one of her constituents working for 50 years. And you have a lot of people out there just like that, worked 40, 50 years, paid into that payroll contribution their whole life. And now they get to a point where they can retire. And they're finding out with their 401k and their retirement plan that they have set up, Social Security is not enough to supplement them so they can live with dignity. And it's amazing. I mean, we're looking at a situation right now where you have lawmakers talking about an increase for Social Security. But guess what? You have more lawmakers talking about, we don't want to do that. We don't want to allow for an increase of Social Security benefits. These people have been working 40, 50 years, but we don't want them to have a little bit of a bump in their benefits. And she also stated, and Representative Larson has stated this as well, let's say you did provide an increase for people receiving Social Security benefits. Guess what? That money's going right back into the community. So if you're a representative and you have a district, you're representing your people. Let's say you go ahead and vote for an increase for Social Security benefits. Let's say you say, okay, yeah, you know what? The Social Security 2100 Act, let's go ahead and pass that. Whether you're a Democrat or Republican, you say, you know what, let's make it bipartisan, let's go ahead and pass this. It provides an increase to those people who are receiving Social Security benefits. Guess where they're spending that money? They're spending that money in their district. They're helping the economy in that district. Small businesses, all the infrastructure of that business will be helped. And so, you know, I know I talk about this a lot. And I've gotten to a point now, just because I've reached that point where I'm able to retire and I have a pension, but I'm still looking forward. I'm still looking forward to at least receiving something in Social Security benefits to help supplement my retirement. And I don't want to be looking at a situation in 11 years where they start talking about cutting Social Security benefits by 23% because our trust fund no longer has money in it. When we can address it right now, this is the time to do it. And so you're going to have lawmakers that are going to sit on their hands. You're going to have some. And the main reason why they're doing that is because they don't want to be honest with the American people. They don't want to say, look, the only way we can fix this is by bringing in more revenue. The only way we can bring in more revenue is by raising the payroll contribution. That's the only way that we can do it. And we're talking long term. Short term, sure, if we have more people working, then those more people working can pay into the payroll contribution. That's a short-term fix. Maybe it'll push it back a year or 2 years. But when we're talking about long-term, 50 years, 75 years from now, we're going to need to bring in more revenue. That's the only way. Or double or triple or quadruple our workforce, which is not going to happen. We know that. And so these lawmakers have to be honest with the American people. That's the only fix. Raising the full retirement age is not enough. It might help by 1 year or 2 years, but it's not going to help for 50 years. So something more has to be done. So I want to know what you guys think. So let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe for more. And I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.